is saying, gentlemen, how are you? I think you are very well. So me, it is Mr. Afe Komi Estino. I am an English teacher in the private school of Togo. And I am here today to continue the help with you through this channel of Television 2. And I greet first of all the director of the channel to have accepted to help us, to help you in this hard time of sanitary crisis. And we are going to study a lot of things today. So I will ask you to come with your notebooks and your pen. So you sit down very well and you follow me. Okay? So we are going to study today the lesson about vocabulary about the coronavirus. Okay? So firstly, we are going to talk about the coronavirus, the vocabulary aspect. And in the second part of our teaching, we are going to talk about the essay writing. Okay? We are going to talk about an essay writing based on the coronavirus that will help you to get prepared for your exams. Okay, so the vocabulary about coronavirus. Now, when one asks you to define what is coronavirus, what are you going to do? Okay, so let us follow, and we are going to come back at the end to explain it to you. Now, the first word we are going to explain is an outbreak. What is an outbreak? Okay, an outbreak is an epidemic. An epidemic. Okay, an epidemic. So an epidemic in French is une épidémie. Une épidémie. Okay, une épidémie, an epidemic, une épidémie. So the coronavirus, for example, or modal sentence, coronavirus is not an outbreak. Coronavirus is not an outbreak, but rather a pandemic. Okay, a pandemic. Coronavirus is not an outbreak, but rather it is a pandemic. Le coronavirus, c'est pas une épidémie, c'est devenu une pandémie. Okay, it is now a pandemic. The second word we are going to learn is a state of emergency. A state of emergency. What does it mean? It is where we want to translate it in French. We can say it is état d'urgence. État d'urgence. Okay, état d'urgence, a state of emergency, état d'urgence. For example, we can say, for our modal sentence, we can say, Togolese government has decreed. Togolese government has decreed. Okay, has decreed a state of emergency. Okay, of 3 months. A state of emergency. The translation in French is état d'urgence. So, for the modal sentence, we can say Togolese government has decreed a state of emergency of 3 months. Ça veut dire quoi? Ça veut dire le gouvernement togolais a décrété l'état d'urgence, ok, de 3 mois. L'état d'urgence sanitaire, bien sûr, de 3 mois. Another word We are going to talk about an illness. An illness. What is an illness? An illness, the synonym of illness is a sickness. A sickness. Okay? A sickness. Or a disease. We can also say a disease. A disease. An illness or a disease. A sickness. Illness, sickness, disease. Those are the different synonyms of the word illness. Now, modal sentence, you can say coronavirus is a bad disease. Okay? Or illness. Coronavirus is a bad disease or illness. Okay? So, an illness, the synonym of illness is a sickness or disease. Modal sentence, coronavirus is a bad disease or illness. Let us continue with another word. Number four, we are going to talk about WHO. Okay? WHO. What is WHO? The definition is World. The definition of WHO, World. Okay, Woman. Okay, World. World. You can say simply World Health. Okay, World Health Organization. Organization. Okay, World Health Organization. In French, it is OMS. Okay, OMS, Organisation Mondiale de la Santé. That is in English, WHO, World Health Organization. Let us talk before the number five, quarantine. Okay, what is quarantine? Quarantine is in French, okay, they translate in French is a quarantine. Quarantine. Okay, that is a quarantine. Quarantine. Now, number six, we are going to talk about the lockdown. Lockdown. The lockdown. Okay? The lockdown is what? The lockdown is le confinement. Le confinement. Le confinement. The lockdown. Le confinement. Number seven, we are going to talk about hydroalcoholic gel. Hydroalcoholic gel. Okay, the translation in French is a gel hydro. Gel hydroalcoolique. Gel hydroalcoolique. Okay, that is alcoholic gel. Gel hydroalcoolique. For a modal sentence, we can say we must disinfect. We must disinfect our hands. We must disinfect our hands. Okay? With a hand sanitizer or with an hydroalcoholic gel. OK? Gel hydroalcoolique. Nous devons nous désinfecter les mains avec le gel hydroalcoolique. So we must disinfect our hands with an hydroalcoholic gel. Now the last word, number 8, it is the social distancing. Okay, social distancing, that is what the social distancing in French we can say in French distanciation sociale. Distanciation sociale. The social distancing. For example, you can say, everybody, we must respect, the social distancing. We must respect the social distancing of 1 meter. Ok, nous devons respecter la distanciation sociale de au moins 1 mètre. Ok, to fight against the coronavirus. So those are some words that we can explain to you that can help you to master your English vocabulary about the coronavirus when you go back to school. When the teacher asks you to describe what is a coronavirus, you must use this word to describe your work. So we are going to take it again. Number one, we talk about an outbreak. An outbreak, that is an epidemic. In French, it is une épidémie. Okay, une épidémie en anglais, it is an outbreak. For the modal sentence, we said that coronavirus is not an outbreak, but rather a pandemic. Qui veut dire en français, le coronavirus n'est pas une épidémie, mais plutôt c'est une pandémie. A state of emergency. A state of emergency in French is a état d'urgence. So in our modal sentence, we talk about Togolese government has declared a state of emergency of 3 months. Le gouvernement togolais a décrété l'état d'urgence de 3 mois. Number 3, we talk about an illness. An illness, the synonym of illness is a sickness, or we can say also a disease. For the modal sentence, coronavirus is a bad disease or a bad illness. So the person that is ill, that the person is sick. The synonym of illness is a sickness. Number 4, we talk about the word WHO. That is a World Health Organization. In French, it's a OMS. So in your translation, quand on vous demande de traduire OMS en anglais, qu'est-ce que vous allez écrire? Ça fait WHO. OK? World Health Organization. And number 5, we talk about the quarantine. Quarantine in French is what? It is a quarantine. OK? Number 6, the lockdown. Lockdown is what? Is a confinement. OK? We are in lockdown. Nous sommes en confinement. Number 7, hydroalcoholic gel, that is a gel hydroalcoolique. For the modal sentence, we talk about we must disinfect our hands with an hydroalcoholic gel. Okay, number 8, the social distancing in French is a distanciation sociale. We must respect the social distancing of 1 meter. Nous devons respecter la distanciation sociale d'au moins 1 mètre. Okay? So that's what we can say for the vocabulary aspect of the coronaviruses. Okay, now I will let you copy for a little bit and we continue with part two. Okay, we continue with part two. I'll give you 2 minutes, you copy, and we come back with the part two. So I will use this time to explain things better for you. When you have an essay, you want to write an essay about coronavirus, you must use these words. You follow the word before the verbs and the objects, so you have the sentence. In English, don't be afraid. Start speaking, okay? I will give you the home assignment right now. You give me one sentence with every word that we have on the board. Vous allez me faire une phrase avec chacun des mots qu'on a essayé d'étudier ce matin. C'est très important. Vous faites une phrase, vous prenez les mots. For example, you can say an outbreak, okay? And you vous formez une phrase en anglais, bien sûr. Okay? You make a sentence before the word. And when you finish, you send your work from my number 9047336 and 9. Donc lorsque vous finissez de travailler, de faire des phrases avec les mots qu'on a étudiés ce matin, vous allez essayer de m'envoyer ça sur mon numéro, le 90 47 33 69. Ok, donc cela va nous permettre de savoir que vous êtes connecté et vous nous suivez. An outbreak, you repeat with me at home. An outbreak, a state of emergency. An illness, WHO, quarantine, the lockdown, hydroalcoholic gel, the social distancing. Okay, I mean you have a copy this part. I will clean this part and continue with the second part of my job. Now we are going to talk about an essay writing. Essay writing. We are going to write an essay on coronavirus. Essay. Essay is a rédaction en anglais, okay? En français, rédaction. Essay. Topic. The topic is what is coronavirus? What is coronavirus? Tell us its causes. Tell us its causes, symptoms, and prevention modes. Okay, what is coronavirus? Tell us its causes, symptoms, and prevention modes. That is the topic you have. Suppose that you are going to exam of BEPC, and in the essay writing, they say, what is coronavirus? Tell us its causes, symptoms, and the prevention modes. What are you going to do? So follow me very well. First of all, your topic, it is an essay. An essay needs 3 parts. Every day when you want to deal with essay writing, you have 3 parts. So the first part is introduction. Introduction. The second part is body. Body. And the third one is conclusion. Conclusion. Okay? So every time when you deal with essay writing, you have to respect these 3 methods. Okay? The first one, we talk about the introduction. After the introduction, the body. And after the body, the conclusion. So, how are you going to be the introduction? Very simple. when you want to deal with the introduction, you take care of the topic. You take the topic into the introduction. For example, they say, what is coronavirus? In your introduction, you say, in my work, I would say, what is a coronavirus? Or I would define the coronavirus. Now they say, tell us it causes symptoms and a prevention mode. And you say, in my essay, I will tell the causes, the symptoms, and the prevention modes of the coronavirus. Okay? So every day you have to respect these three things that you have to notice in the essay writing: the introduction, the body, and the conclusion. Now in the body, now you just give the sentences about what you have to do. Here they say causes, symptoms, and prevention modes. That's it, three things. First of all, you talk about the causes. After that, you talk about the symptoms, and at last we talk about the prevention modes in the body. Now in the conclusion, you are going to sum up. Okay, you just sum up what you have told in the body. Okay, you conclude very simply. So when you look at your exam paper, it's like that. That is your paper. Okay, the introduction, that is the what you have, that is essay. Okay, the introduction will take just 3 lines. That is the introduction. Now you give 1 line. Okay, that is, you start with here, you stop here. Now you give 1 line, that is free, and you start with the body. You see the body, that is the body. It is the part that is very numerous, the body. Now after the body, you give again some lines before you start with the conclusion, and with 3 lines again. You understand? So what we are going to see in your exam paper is like that. That is the introduction, the body, and the conclusion. Okay, the introduction is a small, the body is large, and the conclusion is a small. Always separate the introduction from the body with two or three lines. Here also 2 or 3 lines. You just separate the introduction from the body and the body from the conclusion. Okay, you have to master also some word of word that you need to for transition. Okay, when you start from the introduction to go to the body, you have a word, that a sentence that can lead the first part to the second part, and here also you have a sentence that can lead the second part to the third part. Okay, we are going to practice here. We are going to practice. We are going to practice. We are going to practice here. Okay, our topic is they say, what is coronavirus? Tell us it causes symptoms and prevention modes. Look at the introduction. Introduction, we can say, coronavirus simply is a bad and serious disease. Okay, a bad and serious disease that was discovered in Wuhan in China. That was discovered in Wuhan in China, and was spread okay, and was spread all over, was spread all over the world, okay, all over the world, killing, was spread all over the world, killing about 400,000 people. Okay, so that is your introduction. Coronavirus simply is a bad and serious disease that was discovered in Wuhan in China and was spread all over the world, killing about 400,000 people. Now, that is your introduction. You lay down two or three lines, okay, and you start with the body. So, first of all, we are going to talk about the causes and after the symptoms and the prevention mode. It was caused, okay, by an ill animal, that transmitted, the disease, to human being, okay. Now, as far as the symptoms, are concerned, we can talk, about fever, cough, and difficulty in breathing, For the prevention mode, we must often wash our hands. With a soap and a clean water or disinfect them with a hand sanitizer, we must maintain the social distance, of 1 meter. We must maintain the social distance, of 1 meter between people and us, between people and us. We must wear our muffler whenever we want to go out. So to finish, when we suspect a person presenting the symptom of coronavirus, we must call quickly. We must call quickly 111. Okay, so that is the end of our body. That is the end of our body. Now the conclusion. We are going to conclude now our essay. So to conclude, let us say, to sum up coronavirus is a very bad and dangerous disease but we can overcome. We can overcome it by respecting. We can overcome it by respect. By respecting the sanitary instruction. Okay, that we talked above. Okay, so that is the end of our topic. That's the introduction. That is the body, and here is the conclusion. I'll take it again for you who are at home. You are copy, I know, but you have to understand, okay, very well to know what we are talking about. So the topic was, they say, what is coronavirus? Tell us it causes symptoms and mode of prevention. That is the topic. Now, in the introduction, we talk about what? We say, coronavirus simply is a bad and a serious disease that was discovered in Wuhan in China and was spread all over the world, killing about 400,000 people. The body. It was caused by an ill animal that transmitted the disease to human beings. As far as the symptoms are concerned, we can talk about fever, cough, and difficulty in breathing. For the prevention mode, we must often wash our hands with a soap and a clean water, or disinfect them with a hand sanitizer. We must maintain the social distancing of 1 meter between people and us. We must wear our muffler. Okay, do you know what we call muffler? The muffler. Okay, mask. Okay. We must wear our muffler whenever we want to go out, when we suspect a person presenting the symptoms of a coronavirus, we must call quickly 111. Now, in the introduction, to sum up, coronavirus is a bad disease and dangerous disease, but we can overcome it by respecting the social or the sanitary instruction that we talked above. For you who are not understanding or who are not listening to our English very well, I will take it in French. Nous sommes en train de parler de la maladie qu'on appelle coronavirus. Alors, coronavirus, c'est une très mauvaise maladie qui a été découverte en Chine, ok, qui a été propagée dans le monde entier en tuant environ 400 000 personnes. Alors, la maladie a été causée par un animal qui avait eu le virus, qui a transmis ça aux humains. Alors, selon les symptômes, on peut parler de la fièvre, de la toux sèche ou des difficultés de respiration. Voilà les symptômes de coronavirus. On peut quand même ajouter, puisque on ne peut pas tout dire ici. Pour prévenir cette maladie, comme on l'écoute sur les chaînes, partout, sur les radios, nous allons laver nos mains avec de l'eau et du savon. Nous allons aussi désinfecter les mains avec une solution hydroalcoolique ou un gel désinfectant. Nous devons respecter la distanciation sociale d'au moins 1 mètre entre les personnes et nous. Nous devons porter nos masques à chaque fois que nous voulons faire une sortie ou bien nous restons à la maison. Voilà comment prévenir cette maladie. Et lorsque nous sommes devant quelqu'un qui présente les symptômes de coronavirus, nous allons rapidement faire quoi? Appeler le 111. Et pour conclure maintenant, nous allons dire que pour conclure, tout ça map, pour résumer, le coronavirus est une très mauvaise maladie. Mais nous pouvons vaincre cette maladie-là en faisant quoi? En respectant les instructions qui nous ont données, que ce soit par le gouvernement, par les personnes responsables, les personnes ressources. Nous devons respecter ces instructions. Nous avons parlé de ces instructions déjà dans le devoir. Donc, voici un devoir de rédaction qu'on peut vous demander lorsque les classes vont reprendre bientôt. So you must take it. Don't copy and go and put in your example person. No. Parce que je vous connais bien. Faut pas faire du copy-coller. But that just to help you to know how you can describe, how you can deal with an essay about coronavirus. It can be a topic asking you to write an article. On peut vous demander d'écrire un article concernant le coronavirus or a speech, un discours. Ceci peut vous aider. So that is what we saw today. I will take it again. Firstly, we talk about the vocabulary words according to coronavirus, and we talk about 8 words that we explained with some sentences, some modern sentences, and now we come with the topic. The essay writing about the coronavirus, the topic was what is coronavirus, tell us it causes symptoms and the mode of prevention, and that we are saying. Now, for you who are at home, you don't see well what we put on the blackboard. You want to have the lesson again. Si vous voulez avoir cette leçon en entier, écrivez-nous sur le numéro qui est affiché. Alors, nous allons vous envoyer la leçon par WhatsApp. Ok? Maintenant, si vous voulez sponsoriser cette émission ou bien vous voulez profiter de cette visibilité pour faire voir vos produits, vous êtes une société ou bien vous êtes une maison de production, une maison de vente, vous voulez passer par cette émission pour rendre visible, vous pouvez le faire. Essayez de nous contacter tout simplement et nous allons vous mettre en contact avec la direction commerciale de la télévision deuxième pour sponsoriser cette émission et faire aussi votre publicité. C'est très important. Cela nous permettra de continuer aussi l'émission. Donc, pour les parents qui nous écoutent, vous avez des questions à nous poser. Les élèves qui nous écoutent, vous avez des questions à nous poser. Essayez de nous contacter tout simplement et nous allons être en mesure de vous répondre à toutes vos questions. So, I will stop today here. But I have to talk to thank some people that are helping me with this program. The director of this channel, I thank you. My cameraman, I thank you. Also, I don't know your name, but I thank you. I thank everybody that has followed me with these courses. My name is Mr. Afe Gomi. I will come back again, okay, with another lesson to help you in these hard times. Goodbye and see you tomorrow. Don't forget, always respect, okay, the instruction to avoid the coronavirus. Thank you and see you later.